Yeah, his wife gave him a heter for not for only for only for only for 1 month.
Yes.
Now we start then.
I haven't seen Baruch at all this morning, this afternoon.
What? Start.
What's his name? He's coming up. Simcha. Simcha Moran is coming up right now.
Okay.
I tried to get some other people, but they said they're tired.
Tell me what the best word, pius, to come from the Romi word, peace.
Peace?
Peace, pius in Hebrew. In Hebrew, pius. תעזור לי, גבריאל, איך אני אגיד לפייס מישהו? איזה מילה באנגלית?
איזה מילה?
איזה מילה באנגלית מתאים לזה?
למה?
לפייס מישהו, שמישהו פייס עליי, אני מפייס אותו.
Somebody
to make him be quiet, not be quiet, but to make him
to
give me forgiving.
No,
to make that he will give me forgiving. It's lovely.
Somebody has a hard feeling against another.
Oh, I
forgiveness.
Forgiveness. I mean, to ask forgiveness.
Ask for forgiveness.
I guess the best word to say is to ask forgiveness.
Yeah, before Rosh Hashanah.
Before Rosh
Hashanah. For Michaela, right?
Good. We will start to learn from where I written that we must to ask forgiveness for if somebody...
Mechile.
Yeah. If we damage in money or embarrass him or...
I can ask forgiveness if I know that my son will kill
me. Say, stop. No, not to
write. So he will kill me, let's say it like
that.
הוא ירדוף אחריי להרוג אותי.
לא, תשלח לו מכתב.
יש הלכות לעשות תשובה, מתי לעשות תשובה, מתי כן?
לא, פיקוח הנפש ודאי דוחה הכל, אבל אפשר לשלוח לו מכתב. רב קיוויגר שלח מכתב לפייס מישהו. The search is for where we know that you must ask for giving. מחילה. In the Torah written so, ביום הזה, means יום כיפר, יכפר עליכם לפני השם תתארו. In the front of the Lord, means what it belongs to the Lord, not what belongs to human beings. Something what belongs also to human beings is not enough if you make tshuva. Regular tshuva is not enough. You must ask forgiving from him. And the Chazal learned from this verse, לפני השם, הבנות שבן אדם למקום, יום הכיפורים יכפר, ולא הבנות שבן אדם לחברו. And also written in Mishle. Mishle says so. Beni, im arafta lezor kapecha, lo kashta birupicha, nekadata birupicha, you made something wrong in your mouth, you say something with embarrass or make him angry. Aseh zot eifo beni, what you must do, vinatzel, kibata bekaf reecha, you don't have a break to your friend, lech vitrapes urav reecha, al titen, soon, don't go to sleep. אל תיתן שאלה לך, את מובן אף אחד לך, ינצל כספי, like a deer, soon, run, like a deer, ask him for giving, וכציפור, or like a bird, מפח יפוש, מיד יפוש.
You know what, I have a situation where, you know, I closed my business for 6 months, right? And one of the guys told me that he won't forgive me. So, you know what, I asked my rabbi, he says he's cuckoo, so don't even bother asking.
It depends what happened.
הרב, רק אני רוצה להגיד לך, לפני שבאת התחלתי ל... אתה חי באינטרנט עכשיו, אני עושה בדיקות עכשיו. לא מפריע לך?
מה?
אתה חי בערוץ של הישיבה באינטרנט.
נו.
לא מפריע לך?
לא מבין את השאלה.
נכון, אנחנו עושים את השידור חי של הישיבה. אני צריך לדאוג כמה דברים, אז בגלל זה שלא אמרתי לך, אבל אתה חי במצלמות. אנשים שומעים אותך.
לא אכפת לי.
לא אכפת לך? זה ניסיון שאנחנו עושים עכשיו.
לא אכפת לי. אתה הרי נכנס בין כך ליוטיוב.
לא.
שלי, המצלמה שלי.
נכון.
Also written in the Psalms, chapter 51. לך לבד חטאתי, דוד asked, forgive me for the Lord, for the הרב שלנו. He say, לך לבד חטאתי. My sin is only in front of you. והרב אלף עשיתי. What means? יש הבני ירן, הרב בני ירן explain in his book, שערי תשובה. לך לבד אני נחשב לחוטא, ואינין צריך זו להטיל למחילתך. I must ask forgiving only from you. Why? If you made something for somebody else, for a human being, I asked you. כבר ביקשתי מחילה ממנו וכיפרתי פנה. I don't know many things, but I don't know את ההלכה. If Gentile, if I must ask מחילה from Gentile, this is not written clear. But morality of sure, yes. חיוב, obligation, really obligation, I don't know if I marry a Gentile. I don't know if I must ask forgiving for him or not. In the halakha, re'acha in the Bible, in the Torah, re'acha means your friend like you, what is commanded like you in mitzvot. Re'acha shebekamocha b'mitzvot. But why I ask this question? Because I see Rav Chanina ben Dosa, he say it's an old animal, the wild animal, don't come in Israel, Eretz Yisrael. And he saw a lion coming. He ran after him, saying, what you do here? Run away. And I said, he's thinking, well, what I made it? He come and ask you forgive him. What I tell you, he embarrassed you. Yeah, I understand, I don't understand. I mean, if I bury something, but the revelation created it, it's not nice, it's not honored to Ben Shalom. It could be, you must ask forgiving for a Gentile also, because it's Selam Elohim. In Aloche, I don't find this point. In Aloche, the clear Aloche is, Re'acha, 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 B'mitzvot, I must ask forgiving for a Jew. But for a Gentile, it's nice to ask, to do, but to obligate to do, I can't tell you. Because Re'acha, Re'acha means Jew, irregular halachot, Re'acha means Jew. What the Gemara say about it? Af al pi shenoten lo, if somebody beat or damage his friend, he must pay pitzuyim, kohal.
Kind of
we say pitzuyim.
Damages.
But it's not enough. Say the Gemara, ein nimchal ba'ad shebakesh merev chila. He must also to ask him forgiving. Not enough to pay what it damages. He must ask him also forgiving. And also if somebody is a suspicious his friend, say the Gemara, ha'choshed et chavirot bedavar she'en bo, צריך לכייסו. Also, רבי יצחק say, כל המקנית את חברו, אפילו דברים, if you bother your friend, only with words, you don't beat him, not damage him, only you tell him something not nice, or you embarrass him, or you make him angry. צריך לכייסו, שנאמר, בני אם ערבת לזר כפיך, לך להתרפס ואברך, אם המון יש בידך, תר לו פיסת יד, אם לאו הרבה אלוהים. Means you must ask forgiving. Also, our obligation is a morality obligation, blessing. If you ask forgiving and he say good, I give you, it's better when you bless him. If you need something what you're missing, bless him that you will have it. Because we learn this from, also from what we learn in Shmuel. What say Eli? And he says for Hannah, he was a suspicious Hannah that is a drug, yes? Remember, and he was a suspicious Hannah. He says, Ad matai tishakari, till when you will live to be drug. Then he bless her, Elokei Yisrael yiten lach shelatech. Also pray for him. Paroi asked from Virachtel Gamati, asked Moshe, when you go out from the Egypt, bless me. Because of the Medr Shagodun, Mikana Tomer, Shaya Yudashem Chusar Tfilah, Ben HaKadosh Baruch Hu Mochel Lo Le'adam, Mat Shefes Et Chavero. Ve'ne'emar, כשהמלך הזיר את שרה לאברהם, פיסו על כך, והתפלל אברהם על הלכים, ויפלק את אברהם, את המלך. So, when he asked for forgiving, he you must pray for the Lord for the man what he what I made in bed. Because I made him something wrong, so I must pray for him that will be better with his situation. It's also like Tshuvat HaMishkal. You made him bad, you must do for him good. Balance, this is the balance, if you will. So the Bashit explaining. לפני שהוא חטא בציור חברו, so ask, you pray for him something, or you bless him, or you pray for him something what he needed.
What did you say? Pray for him something he needs?
And this is also opposite. When you ask for giving, tell him also pray for me, because I was a sinner. I made it wrong. If I be a sinner, pray for me also. Abraham, he gives for Abimelech, he must pray for Abimelech. But they say also opposite. This is something what is new. The Shita Kubetz say also opposite. Okay. What is obligation to ask for giving? Achet klape azulat, if somebody stole, or the beat is not only sin for the human, for the man, the sin of also the Lord. Are you in the Torah? Lo tigzol, lo tignob. There's both, there's double sins. The sin for the Lord and sin for the man, but he has the problem for me. Achet klape azulat is also chet klape kadosh, because this says in Marshal, when he asks forgiving, not ask only forgiving for him, tell him, Chatati l'Elokei Yisrael v'lecha, tislach li. I must mention also, but I don't never saw this custom. Marshal say, when you go to ask forgiving, tell him in this language, Chatati l'Elokei Yisrael v'lecha be'avon ploni, ploni, tislach li. Because you must remember that if somebody made wrong, it's not only between you and him, is between the Lord also. It's all written in the Torah, it's the real. יש איסורי נעת חבר, או עבירה מצאת אבטח כמוך, גזל, בכל מקום, what is something that this is new? You must ask forgiving also from the man. Not enough what you make tshuva for the Lord, to ask forgive for the Lord. You must ask forgiveness also for your friend. Why you must ask forgiveness? 2 points. To make him comfortable, that you know, not feel bad, it's for him. So if for myself say nothing, I not care, nothing happened, but you don't ask him the forgiving, it's not enough. Our 2 points. The kapara, the confession, the profession for you, if you go and you ask, you embarrass yourself and you go ask him forgiving. If you have, ask him in this form, or send him a letter, or send a messenger to a friend to ask for.
Aren't you asking, when you're asking for, like in my case, where I have to lay the guy off, because I have to come to Israel, you know? I hired him and then I had to tell him, listen, I'm going to Israel. And he's upset, okay? So it's my rabbi says, forget it. But the thing is, if I
tell him again exactly what happened.
I told the guy that I'm going to give him a job for 6 months and then I had to leave after 3 months.
You promised him to give him a...
For 6 months. But the guy was never working hard. Half the time he was talking on the phone, you know, doing jokes, you know, and he wasn't serious when he worked, okay?
Second
brother. Yeah, acted like an idiot. But the thing is that, you know, I went to my rabbi, he says, don't take this guy seriously, because one time...
If we, anyway you want to send him away, but if you want...
Yeah, I wanted him to leave, okay, anyways. But the thing is that he feels that I did him wrong, and he says, I'm not going to mochel you.
I'm not much of you.
Yeah, you're not going to walk with you.
I thought that means be lenient. Oh, be lenient with you?
No, what is lenient?
Easy
here? I don't understand.
You know, and his wife is mad at me too. And, you know, she's a good woman. But the thing is that The thing is, you know, I mean, she doesn't understand. Her husband's an idiot. So it doesn't really matter. So the point I'm trying to make is I asked my rabbis, and they said, forget about it. Go to Israel. It's more important for you to go to Israel, learn Torah, okay? And, you know, because it wasn't...
Well, not so simple. If it was contract...
There was no written contract.
No verbal. Oral contract is also contract.
Okay, so... yeah.
But if his work not was well, and you won't send him anyway...
His work was garbage. Like, I mean, he never worked. Lots of times he would call me and say, my wife's sick, I don't feel like coming into work. Or he would call me and say, listen, I'm busy, I gotta take care of the kids, I don't have time to work today. Even though I paid him up, look, I paid him all the money up front for a job, okay? I gave him all the money, and then he didn't show up.
So, but don't know the story.
Okay, it's not important. The point is, I hired him and I gave him money up front. And he, you know, for 3 months I gave him money, and he didn't come in. Lots of times he would call me and says, I'm busy, I can't work today. You know, like, I wanted to fire him anyways, okay?
He must hear the second...
Exactly. But the point is that my rabbis know both sides, and they told me, just go to Israel.
Okay? Let's not go to Israel. Listen, go to Israel is not a reason. He's not good worker, it is a reason.
No, he wasn't a good worker, for sure.
Not okay. Because you want to go to Israel,
yeah.
Only because his work...
Yeah, his work was horrible.
Rabbi,
he didn't show up half the week, okay?
No,
when he did show up, he was talking on the phone all the time. It wasn't working.
But another reason is not enough.
Here's the big
this
problem.
This is the reason, you can't tell me
here's,
the reason.
Here's the best problem, he's my best friend. Okay, so that's what makes him complex.
No,
I haven't talked to him since I left. But here's the problem, Rabbi.
Third point, why you ask for forgiving?
Because if I ask for forgiveness, I'm admitting that I did something wrong. He should be asking me for forgiveness.
You don't get it.
Because if I ask you for forgiveness...
We want to continue.
No, but that's the first part of this. Why should I admit I'm doing something wrong?
I don't know what happened. So, your rabbi, it was mixed, is good enough for me. Enough for me that your rabbi, you know.
No, okay, forget my case. Why should you ask the person for mechila? Because aren't you admitting you did something wrong then? If you're not sure, why should you ask for mechila? Then you're admitting you did something wrong.
No, if I sure that I make wrong, I must make him be quiet.
What if you're not sure? What is 50-50?
Better to ask for Chile.
What if you didn't do anything wrong?
Something the way said the home way. We have every doubt. It's better to be strict.
So if you're not sure, you should always ask, even though you're embarrassing yourself and putting your self down.
Yes, because what you're embarrassing yourself is not so bad.
The guy might say to you, I told you were wrong, you didn't know, I told you you were wrong.
Yeah, right. Let's say somebody comes up to you and says, hey, could you help me out with some money, I need money, and you give him $5, because that's all you have, and he goes, I really wanted 10, and he's mad at you the whole time. Do you go and apologize to him afterwards just for the sake of making shalom with him, even though you gave him $5, and he said, oh, he wanted 10?
No. I don't feel that you're obligated to him anything.
But he's mad at you, and he wants you to
run. Well, he won't. His problem is
okay.
Well, here's more complex. Suppose you told him at some point, you know, when you need help, I will help you. And then he finally asked you for $100, and you give him $50.
The main point that we must talk now is saying, Erev Yom Kippur, Tefillah Zakor, I forgive for everybody, is not enough. Because you must also to go to ask him. At least with a letter or a phone call, at least, because also before Yom Kippur are a special obligation, because to make the whole nation one nation, because the Mechile is not only for a single person, it's for the nation together. So if somebody is spread from the nation, because it's not as forgiving, not good. It's very bad. This is the point where if you know what it means to bother somebody, you will be very careful not to do it. People make jokes and they don't scare.
I'm
maybe
so
you will
sorry
bother.
For making fun of you all. Could you forgive me for your anger?
No.
I hope.
if bus shake you and you fall on somebody, but you must forgive or not.
Yeah.
Not clear by me, because the rabbi say in the Vokame, when he's covered with sorrow, he wasn't in his attention to make him bad. From this language I learned, maybe if you be, when you follow somebody, the bus is his responsibility, not you. Because sometimes when he stopped.
Ah, okay, but don't we say that if, let's say you...
But sometimes when you ask, and by my...
If you
the rabbi is saying, זה שנזכבן לצערו, שנזכבן לצערו, you have attention to make him bad. נזכבן, he's to say only the language of the rabbi. But I believe that you must ask for forgiving. This is very often in the bus, when the bus starts to travel, he shakes you.
You hit somebody else. So you have to ask him for mechila?
Yes. Let this excuse yourself.
And what if he tells you to go jump in the Dead Sea?
Well, what are you going to do?
Tell him thanks.
What?
It's a good thing for the skin.
I need some therapy.
I thought you have to ask mechila 3 times.
Not on a bus ride.
But you told me on your birthday 3 times, right? You have to ask, right, Rabbi?
No, it's the end of the year, they say that's what it says, right? We learned that.
According to the Rosh, what the Rosh said, because we must be the whole nation together, even in not right. According to the Rosh, I feel that you must ask forgiving even in not right. But I don't know what to do. Because
3 times?
Wait.
Okay. I'm waiting.
Right. But I don't know if you know the story, Rabbi Rashad Mizamel Aybach, you hear the name, I'm sure. Shmirat Shabbat Kilchata, you know the book.
Yeah, but I don't know if I read that story.
No, you know the book. Rabbi Aybach.
Shmir Hashav
Kilchosa, he's a rabbi of the... He was...
I don't think so.
He was a rabbi from Neuver. When he was in the funeral for his wife, you know what he say? The custom is to ask forgiveness for the wife before I buried her. And I assure that I don't need to ask forgiving, because the whole life we was together like Shulchan Aruch, we don't not ask any forgiving, you don't need to ask any forgiving. This is something amazing. Why? Many times you give compliment to somebody and he feels opposite, you mean embarrassing. But you, from your side, you was right. You say compliment, you want to say good for you. What he feel bad is his problem. According to Rav Zalman, I feel that if you was right, even his meaning was opposite what you want to do to do for him. You don't need to ask forgiving, but according to Rosh, I feel that Rosh say it must be the whole nation together. It's also if you mean he has a mistake, he means that you made him bad, but you sure that you don't know nothing bad, you done anything bad for him. You know the story, your rabbi says you right, but you feel bad. Better to ask him forgiving. According to the Rosh meaning.
Yeah, but then you're admitting that you were the wrong
one. Oh, you can. What is the signal you're bad? What you care?
But he was the bad one.
Yes, but if I tell you...
That's why you have to let your ego go.
Listen to the story. I tell you a story, but I don't accept it. I don't understand it. Not like that. I don't understand it. The rabbi of Israel Salander, you heard the name?
Yeah.
Yeah. His rabbi was of Zundu. Misalat. You have the standard, you know what the standard.
Standard, I make them.
Standard.
Yeah, I make them, for sure.
Yes, standard was a drawer. Mm. And the standard was full books, was very heavy.
What?
Somebody liked the standard. Every day, he took the standard, his private standard, and he removed it to his place, and he asked him, I let you take my standard, but bring back also. Was so embarrassed, the man, but told him to bring back. And he was asking forgiving, was crying, give me up, forgive me. I don't understand the story. According to Rosh, could be understood. They want to make arguments inside. Even in the guy who took the stand, Gazdan, Shel Shel Avidas Gazdan. He but he told him I not care, I let you. But be a Ben Adam, be a man, not be a pig. What is to take something that not belong to you, and he ask you to put back in this place what you would remove it, and he goes, no, he's assaulted. Even so, he was asking once, two, and he was like, forgive me, forgive me. I don't know this as a story. Only shooting the Rosh, Ardus. This story, very important to remember it. Even I don't understand it. But the story from Rav Orbach, I believe that I feel that he say, if I be right, even you made mistake and you feel bad, many times you want to say something, you know, because we must be very careful what you say. Because many times you say something good, and who hear half of this is very embarrassed. Happened by your simple.
What? When I say something and someone took it the wrong way?
The listener was very embarrassed because he hear only half.
Only half? I mean,
it translates badly. So many times happen. If you must forgive
or not. Don't ever do business deals with your friends. Trust me.
Hey, here's a question. What if somebody, like you say, okay, you know what? Let's say you want to get something from the store. You say, here, take this money and buy me this get this type of thing, yeah? He goes to the store, he gets something cheaper. And he doesn't give you the money, and then and he goes, will you forgive me?
This is a momentous question. I don't want to mix this. Now we're talking of only forgivings.
No, I'm saying it comes here.
It depends why he give you a cheap. If because he loved you, then it belongs to you. If because you bring the money, it belongs to who gave the money. This is more. It's not now the time.
I'm saying,
leave it.
The point is, I just want to give somebody about money issues before he pays you back.
No. We don't mix. You mix something else here. I don't know to mix any other things. We want to learn forgivings. There are lots of forgiving.
Yeah, I'm saying, if he still owes you the money, do you forgive him? Or do you have to get the money first?
No. This is another question. It's not...
How do you feel? Do you want to forgive the guy?
I'm not going to get my money, but I'm required to forgive him. That's the question.
Well, because here's why. You remember what the other rabbi said? If God has to punish him, then you have to get some of that punishment. He stays with you forever, the punishment.
No. Listen. Boys, listen. Avirot sheben adam lechaviro, tzarich lefayes et chaviro. And your keeper not healthy, don't ask him forgiving, not nothing. Not Isurim, not death, and nothing. Till you ask forgiving for your friend. What means? So, if it's an economic problem, if you suffer him like you take violent, or you damage his body, he was suffering, you must ask for forgiveness also. But if the only money question, you know, when you pay him back, you finish your goal, you pay him back. But Sefer Hasidim say, no, if he can't make this, if he could take this money or make this business, then you make him, that he have less money because you hold the money by you. You must ask him forgiving also because he want to say not only ask forgiving, pay or magic I must have in the bank, credit in the bank, how much can pay. This is business Hasidus, not a lot.
For sure.
Not a lot, the business Hasidus. But to ask forgiving is could be right. Because he lose money. Put in the bank or interest to take money for this, say,
accrued interest. Yeah. A very tough situation.
This point was just talking before. if you made something without attention to make wrong, you want to make good. And happen something by the, what is the doctor? Make operation and the patient die. Many times happen. Chassam Sefer say, if you go to save somebody and you made a mistake, is very less sin. Even to kill somebody, v'shoigeg, is our goal, as you know. So, sometimes, could be, you see somebody fall, and you
catch him
and sometimes you catch him too strong. It's healthy, if you must ask forgiveness or not. According to the, I was happy that I found the rabbi. The rabbi said, this covenant tzaro, you have attention to make him bad. But if you work for him and you made him,
Okay, so if you have intent, but that's so strange, because some people are just very negligent. They just don't pay attention. They don't care enough to pay attention. They walk down the street, he doesn't, I don't want to bump into Yaakov. I'm just walking, bloop, 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 I'm not paying attention, and I don't know what, I walk right into him. I'm not thinking, oh, I should do that. Here in Israel, I have it all the time. All the time, people walk right into me. They are so rude. They don't care.
But you know, at the Kotel, I saw a guy, a rabbi, you know, a white beard, black hat and everything. He was walking really, really fast and he smashed right into a soldier and he fell down.
The soldier fell?
No,
the rabbi bounced off the soldier.
He bounced right off and right onto the ground. The
just the thing, they walk right into people. Do they need to be apologists? Because most of them don't, I can tell you that much. People walk right into
people. You know what he did? He just got back up and he kept walking.
Well, yeah, very often is the bus. When you go, the bus starts to...
But the bus is different, because in the bus...
When the bus travels, you fall
right,
on the...
But it may be
or he goes over a big bump and you're going to wipe out into
but
the bus.
But that's different, because that's like, oh, you're in the bus and you're somewhat at the mercy of how the bus moves in that case. But in the case of how you're just walking, it's only you.
No. Sometimes you go and you fall to the other people. I don't know who is falling, but... Whose fault is? Sometimes you go and it's not accident, but you go in inside and people will come
right and things like that. But no, but that's not how it is here on the street. People just walk right into it. Okay. Israelis are very rude people.
Many times you go and
not you, Rabbi.
No, when you go, sometimes the hand. When you go slow.
One of them hit me in my genitals with his hand. Can you believe this one? He was swinging his arm. That guy actually did apologize. That was nice.
I had a woman do that already here.
One heel abuse.
Why?
When you must ask the forgiving.
In
Mishle say, אל תיתן שינה לך, don't go to sleep, go ask forgiving soon, don't wait, but ערב יום כיפר, you must do it.
Oh, great.
I gotta
call my friend.
Yeah.
No.
את מי חייב לפייס? To who, for who you must ask forgiving?
Fire, man.
Every Jew also, next family, the parents, children, brothers, sisters, wife and husband. You don't say, if she forgive me, you ask as direct forgiving. Before Yom Kippur, and also the rabbi asks the congregation, in the Esther community, in the speech. Also in the synagogue, by the small synagogue, you know what they do. Before Kol Nidre.
What?
Timchalu, they say, the rabbi say, Timchalu ze la ze, and everyone say, Machalnu, Machalnu, Machalnu.
Yeah, I remember that, yeah. Okay.
Yes, but this is a Sfat custom. But us, we have in the Sidur, תפילה זקו, אז forgive for everybody.
What does Timchalu mean?
Give up, forgive.
Forgive us, forgive us.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it's like if you ever go to a Sephardi for Yom Kippur service, it's totally different than Yashinan. I like it better. But anyways,
No, but Ashkenaz we say in the Siddur, Tefillah Zakah also,
yeah.
Also.
Yeah, but it's different, it's not the same words.
No, the same, as Mochel Kol Echad. Also before the sleep.
Yeah.
Before you sleep also, Ribono Shel Olam Marino.
Yeah, you say it every night, that I forgive everybody, I forgive everybody, I don't want nothing on my head, you know? We're all, Thursday night, we're all going to the Kotel for Salifah. And it's mostly Sephardi, but what's it called? Rabbi Rabbi Goldstein said that it's very, very good. Starts at 11 o'clock on Thursday night, so we hug.
So,
how do you get home, though? You're going to have to walk home. Is there any buses after Salichot on Thursday night?
And also you must ask forgiving for a dead man.
How?
How you take,
you
must,
you go to the grave and you ask for forgiveness?
Yes, yes. You must take 10 people.
Oh, 10 people.
10 people and to say, Chatati l'Elokei Yisrael l'Elokei Nizeh, and they say, Mochel Lecha, Mochel Lecha, Mochel
Lecha. That's Hatarat Neduim, right?
For banning,
you have to do it 10 people, the Hatarat
Neduim. On his tomb, you must go to his...
Oh, you have to do it at his gravestone?
At the grave.
And what is when when the dead is buried kilometers away?
You send the messenger. You are allowed to send messenger. You don't need to. It's far from you, but you don't need to go by yourself. You can't.
Just, did you hear what he just said?
Yeah.
If it's a dead person,
if
and you haven't had a chance to say.
No, if he wasn't alive and he became dead.
That's what I just said. Let me finish. If the guy dies before you had a chance to ask for forgiveness, you have to
you
go
must
to the
take
grave 10
people.
10 people.
To the cemetery, to his grave.
I'll skip on that one.
Skip on it.
I'm pretty sure the dead guy's not going to care. He's dead.
He's so low.
Yeah.
Sold away the life.
Yeah. In a certain way. What if he's a real big Raja and his soul gets destroyed completely? Because he gets Karas. He gets Karas.
You can't know that.
You
can't possibly know that.
So
also, let me tell you something. Even if he's a Raja, you still have to ask for forgiveness.
But his soul's been destroyed.
No,
well, you don't have to from Raja?
Raja is not you may... Raja is Abu Nazar Lopez.
If the guy's a Russia, you don't have to ask for forgiveness?
But Rosh is not so simple to...
Because we don't know if he's a Russia. Hashem knows only.
No, because...
Do I have to go to Hitler's grave?
Rosh means...
Yeah, no, he's a Russia, don't worry.
Not so simple to find a Rosh.
He said, do I have to go to Hitler's grave to ask for forgiveness?
Because...
Do you know where
Rosh is, you must say rebuke to Yehochem. Rebuke to Chacham. You must tell him that you're wrong, you don't know how to do it. Nobody was safe, or you see somebody not religious. But maybe the education was so... No, nobody told him that you're going the wrong way. Rosh is not so simple. Better not to talk bad even about Rosh Gentile. It's a big problem in the newspapers. Because the newspapers tell many, many things somebody make wrong, and the news talk about it. Lashon Hora, it's many times Lashon Hora, but many times. I tell you something not simple. If you want to hear about Lashon Hora, I have something, but I wanted to think about it. The Chubun, the temple became destroyed. Why?
The second temple because of...
The first temple.
First temple for death and murder and stealing.
This was the finish.
No, the first
this
one because of...
This was the finish.
The sexual
affection,
idolatry and
wash your hands.
Offing people.
Yeah,
this was
the
finish.
Yeah.
This
no, you can't learn Torah until you wash your
wash your hands again.
This was...
Do I have to go wash my hands now?
Yes, if you touch your foot or your
no,
shoes.
No, I tied my shoelaces, that's all.
But you touch the shoes also?
No, but you know what?
But Halacha in the Kitzur says if you tie your shoelaces,
you
have to wash.
Only the tiles, you don't need to
if
wash.
You touch your shoes?
Only
hey,
the
my
leather.
Son, the sandals are cool, I have no shoelaces.
No, you have to, no, if you touch the shoes, you have to wash them.
I did not touch them.
What about when you milkered them?
What?
When you put that together.
If you make damage, economic damage, and you don't know to who you belong to pay, you must give charity in the city, must belong to the whole city. Charity for not private poor people, only something with the public, like hospice.
Funding
giving.
The so-called
like
Kupat Ha'ir, right?
What?
The so-called Kupat Ha'ir, right?
Kupat Ha'ir, no. Kupat Ha'ir is not good. Because Kupat Ha'ir is only for poor people.
You
must give or something that is belong to the old city, like a hospital, like synagogue, or road to make road, something that belong to the city, to the people that can use it. So, Rabbi, but if you give a Kupat Ha'ir, that is not good, because only it's special charity for poor people.
Mm-hmm.
Better to give to a hospital or a Gmilas Chasodim. You know what is gmach?
Yes.
Gmach, to a gmach, something
like that. I go to the yellow door. That's in Arnuf. Got this 10 shekel.
So if somebody asks you for charity and you just walk away and he starts calling you a mamzer and says he's not going to forgive you.
He must ask him forgive for you.
He has to ask you for forgiveness?
Yes.
Okay.
I gave
yes,
somebody asked me, I gave them shekel. They throw away the shekel.
Badly.
I elevated it. I told him, and I went. He threw away the shekel. He wanted more money.
I've seen people will do that. If you give them money, less money than they want, they'll yell at you.
Yeah, I was happy that they gave him 5 shekels at the wall. I mean, right before the woman, that guy, I gave him 5 shekels.
No, 5 they'll usually be happy with.
Yeah, he didn't say anything to me.
I don't think they'll be
happy. Even 1 shekel, the people didn't say anything back. So
one time I gave a lady 2 shekels.
No,
there
are people that you give 1 shekel, the feel that you embarrass them.
Are you serious?
I mean, that is his problem. I don't need to give him. I don't know him.
If you're wearing an expensive suit or something, I can understand. They maybe think that you are...
I don't know who he is. This is also one of the problems, if you need to ask him forgiving.
So what, you go there dressed
if like
a
half shekel?
Money,
yeah. If I give many people mm-hmm. would collect money, and I never we know that poor people or not. Sometimes we know that people who collect money is very rich. The story by Rabbi Yochanan was a very interesting story. Was a poor people who collect money. He did not he collect money like poor people. And say, I will give you after when I go to the Beit Merchatz to wash myself, to the mikveh.
Yeah.
When I come out from the mikveh, I will give you. When he come out from the mikveh, he find him that die. He's so very surprised. He start to work for him. He sees his pocket was full of money. He was so cheap that he don't want to buy food also. He was very rich, but he died from hunger because he was very cheap, not to buy bread. He liked so much the money.
That sounds kind of unrealistic. Probably it's an allegory because
it's happened. I've seen people like this when he's talking about
it. No,
but not to this extent.
The Gemara say, because this
yeah,
story, the Gemara say, we must be grateful for the people, but the false people.
Oh, because they stop us from
because,
giving affairs.
Because we don't know, limud zchot of us, we don't, maybe if you don't give charity, because you can't tell the Lord, I'm not sure that he needs it. Many times the people would collect money for drugs.
Yeah, I can't tell. You know what the quota
is? Yeah, but you know what? They probably need that money to get drugs.
So
even the old lady with the can.
So I give
the
beer. But they come to the synagogue, the religious people who come to collect. I give him half shekel or shekel. Half shekel or half shekel.
What's a half shekel going to give him?
Because
yeah,
half shekel is nothing, but few half shekel is money. But to the, if
you can't even buy a can of pop unless you have 5 minutes.
When he became embarrassed for you, so don't give him much more money. I don't know if you need to ask him for giving. Is this problem? I don't need to give him more. I don't know him.
Can you
what if you don't give him at all?
Also, what?
What if you just don't feel like it? You don't trust him.
I heard the rabbi what he say: don't give people what you don't know him. Because sometimes people are bad things.
Yeah, what if he calls you a manger and spits on you?
He must ask you much forgiving. He's very bad.
No,
he has to forgive you then if he spits on you and calls you a manger?
Of course.
You must ask for forgiving.
He did insult you very,
top.
Very badly.
So, you forget to give money and you don't know to who? Give Sidur in Kotel or give Sidur in the Central Synagogue.
Where?
Central Synagogue. Synagogue Central.
You donate a Sidur?
If you obligate to pay to somebody you don't know who. You damage somebody you don't know who is this. You don't have to pay.
What did
an help say, brother? You don't know to who to pay. Yasser Sofran or hospital. Oh, Sidur in the Kotel, in central places. Go to central places and give there something what you can't serve for the nation.
1750.
Normal time. You gotta go. I forgot something.
What time is it?
I promise somebody something. Is it really 5 to 6? Really?
It is ten to six.
I promise somebody.
Ask his forgiveness.
Yeah, I got that.
If you know that you were to you must pay somebody, you don't know who is it, who you, where is it, put in Bezdin, but now I don't know which Bezdin will take it. Sefer Hasidim says something interesting. If somebody stole and you don't can pay back because you're not here and you don't know how to find him, give to his relative. I don't understand why to give a relative. Or he say, if not a relative here, give it also to the public. Also, if you are in a line and somebody took your line, in bank or to the bus, and you miss time, you must also just forgive you, because it's like he stole you from the time. Rights of this is copyright.
Copyright
also, you must be careful not
to infringe on someone's copyright.
You must learn the law of copyright also.
In Judaism, do we have that? Do we have...
You don't know how to... If you damage his panose, it's sure. But if you are owner of your knowledge, it's not so simple. Rabbi Yashiv saying to me, knowledge is also property. Your knowledge is also property. So you don't can make copy without his... permission. It's so insane. Other people say knowledge is not reality. Reality is not stole, something reality, money, you damage his panose, is also forbidden. But it's not his panose, it's not panose. Only your ownership. He don't want to let you to make a copy on, not because it makes business. If it makes business, they don't allow to make a competition because it belongs to him. It's his rights. But it don't make for this money. And it don't want to give you permission only when you pay. And what you say is also our ownership of knowledge. Okay. It's something what's the question?
I got a question. Is there a difference between copyrighted materials from Jew to non-Jew?
No, because not allowed to store Gentile also.
Well, is pirate copying...
But I don't want to go inside this. I told you all what only was this simple. Now they talk about forgiving, it is forgiving. It's not so simple what you ask me now.
Do you have to go to each person individually? Can you just say it's everybody?
No. No, because they say clearly that you must ask private directly.
Can someone just say to everybody, I forgive anybody who did something wrong to me?
Yes, we say every night we forgive, but it's not enough. Because our obligation also to Boris himself, go and ask him. So see the poskim. Even the searches was trusted in these searches from there they learned that you must ask forgiving. Even he forgive you for yourself,
Now what if two people, what if one of them said, oh, you're stupid, the other person said, no, you're stupid, yeah? Now, neither one of them wants to go to apologize because he says, that guy should apologize to me, too. They both have to apologize, but neither one of them is going to do it because then... Or what if one of them apologizes, the other person does not apologize, and then he feels like, why?
Second, if somebody says you're stupid and you say back, is could be you don't need to ask forgiving because you do, because you want to save yourself. You don't want to let him to embarrass yourself. You allow to keep yourself from if somebody wants to embarrass you. You wait to save yourself. In the second guy, I don't sure that he must ask forgiving, but the first guy he must ask forgiving of sure. Even you say him back, you are stupid. Somebody told you you are stupid, and you ask him back, and you say him back, you are the stupid. The first guy of sure must be asked to forgive him. The second guy could be not, because he start to make the problems. When he starts with the problems, like also, if somebody beat you, and you beat him back. Also the same point. According to the Pashas Aloha, you don't need to ask him forgiving because he starts.
He started.
And you want to save yourself.
Yeah.
Yes, yes, it's important the question that you're asking. If, when you regard of somebody who paid you, or bad, and you are glad of this, if you must ask him to give him or not. If too much, you give him too, you beat him much more than what he done with you, then you ask him for forgiving. But if you made like what he done for you, this is your rights to save yourself. If somebody, Motsi Shema, I know what Motsi Shema, I say something wrong with of somebody else when he's not right to do it. It's lies. If somebody say, blood libel, they say on you, then you don't need to forgive me. But in a society is also to forgive him. Because why is it not known? Because sometimes even he has forgiving, but many people believe that what he says is true and don't know that he has forgiving. Also a new question by me but not clear. If somebody buries wife, a married wife, he must ask forgive for his husband or not. Because if somebody buries your wife, you feel bad also. Also, a child, somebody buries a child, even though he has to ask for him from the palace. Because I feel bad for him. For me, it's not clear. I think the search of Gemara that shows it could be that he buries for him. If somebody curses a man, and you don't know that you curse him, also when you're so suspicious somebody, and you don't know that you're so suspicious of him, and you're not suffering, it was you by yourself. Could be that you don't need to ask for giving. By me, this point not true. Gemara was saying, "Achachoshe bechavi rotzech lefais," or he must ask for giving. This is when he told him, like Eli said to Hana, "Why you be drunk? He embarrassed her." After when he was so suspicious, but if you're so suspicious, only in your heart, and not sure that you must ask. If you bring somebody to make a vire, also I mean that you must ask him for giving, because it's not a moral damage, it's just a soul.
No, damage in this world and damage in the next.
You must go to ask not enough and he forgive everybody, like what we say every night. Not enough. And not enough to ask generally for the questions, not specially. And the Katrina better to go by yourself, not phone call, not letter, not messenger, but if you meet, that you will be more accepted when you send a letter. Because when I show you that you remember, you mentioned the whole problem that you done it. or to ask, by yourself or you must bring three people together with you? How do they? Shulchan Aruch say, go with three people to ask for giving. But in the Pashas HaGemore, if you learn the Gemore, first of all, you go by yourself to ask him. If he don't want to forgive you, then you take three people to help you to ask him forgiving. And if even not help, you bring another three people. If not help, you bring another. Later you say, before 10 people, I ask him forgiven, and he doesn't accept it. So, if they must know that it's very important point here to know this, that if somebody don't want to forgive you, you they call it cruelty. You must, Rambam says so, in the Rambam, the language of Rambam is so. Kiva shebikesh meina achoyle. You meet somebody and you ask him for giving, you pay him and you want to have forgiving. Vekivesh mena choyle, but he's chanelai, he asks very much, he's chanelai. He was humble to him, pam rishona v'shniya, say, first time and second time. V'rishona v'shniya, is, from the Rambam, understand that, could be that don't need come so you are yes, I forgive you. Could be you must allow to wait that he could feel that he means serious. If you see that he means serious, it's a mitzvah to give him up. If for a reason not to give him up, you may not to give up. But in heart, you will give up. You say, if you have a reason for this. more of the